As you know, we had a regulation passed, an emergency regulation that allows the issuance of citations. It also begins with warnings. So after a couple of warnings and perhaps a dispersal order, there is the potential for the issuance of citations. They will also be checking up on locations that may or may not be following the rules and reporting back on places that have liquor licenses, that have gaming licenses, that are not following the rules, and those places will be subject potentially to having proceedings initiated against them to remove their gaming or their liquor licenses. And it's not just Region 1. It's in any region in which we have existing mitigations that we've asked people to follow, and we're going to ask the businesses, as the regulation, you know, outlines, to do what they're supposed to do, and we'll hold them responsible if they're not.
And just to follow up to that, I know you have one kid's other questions. You know, and I'm sure you've seen online, a lot of people are not, they said they're done, their livelihoods, they're not going to put their employees' jobs on the line, they're not going to, you know, ruin a family business that they've had for 80 years, and they're determined to stay open. What are you going to do? I mean, what?
Well, let's.
I know you understand you don't want to ruin their livelihoods. I get that. Mm-hmm. And I know we want to slow the spread. I get that. But at what point in time, you know, people are going to start fighting back.
Yeah.
And the best of the way that they know how, and that's how they choose to do it.
I understand. And I understand how difficult it is. I do. Many small businesses have their entire livelihoods at risk and the potential for the closure of their business permanently as a result of this virus. The difficulty, I think, is that some of the locations, and remember, this is often focused on bars and restaurants because those are super spreading locations, that some of those locations, when they remain open, when they don't follow the rules, they are, in fact, helping to communicate this virus to many other people in their communities. This is an awful virus. One of the challenges of it is that it isn't visible to anybody and it doesn't occur to you right away. In other words, it's not that you'll show up at a bar or restaurant one day and the next day you're sick. That's not how it works. And so it's very difficult for people to understand and then, you know, to try to manage that with the financial pressures that they're going through. And we've tried to alleviate some of the burden of that with our business interruption grants, with PPP at the federal level. There's much more that's needed to keep people going financially through this pandemic. And we've been fighting to get those resources to small businesses in Illinois. And I'll continue that fight. For whatever reason, that isn't happening. The federal officials, federal congressmen, senators, the president can't seem to get together to get that done. So what I can say is that unfortunately we still have to live by the rules here because we don't want people to get sick and die. And so I would ask people to try to live by the rules that we've set. Wear your mask. The truth is that if everybody will wear their masks, we can get our businesses back open again much quicker.
We are. I mean, I don't.
No, you are. I can see you're wearing a mask right now.
Yeah, but I mean, out in the streets and at bars and gyms, you know, even people running, you know, jogging alone, everyone seems to be wearing a mask, but it's
that's
not working. So what's...
That's not true, Amy. Masks work. There are a lot of people not wearing their masks, and a lot of people who are having private events at their home, and they're not wearing masks in their home. There are a lot of people, as you know, the unfortunate thing about bars and restaurants, as opposed to other kinds of retail, for example, is that in order for you to enjoy being at a bar or restaurant, you have to take your mask off. And it is often the case that people will sit for an hour, 2 hours, maybe longer, without their mask on. And, you know, it's a place where you're speaking louder than normal, usually, because there's noise in the place. I mean, the natural things that people do in bars and restaurants, unfortunately, are exactly the natural way in which this virus transmits. Masks work. But I can tell you, because I have traveled this entire state, there are an awful lot of people not wearing masks. And right here in Chicago, that's true.